In a previous video, we introduced you to the power of DeepSeek VL2 for OCR. Now, get ready to dive even deeper. This will be an advanced exploration of DeepSeek VL2 for OCR, where we'll be pushing its limits by asking for more sophisticated information from several complex images. Stick around until the end to find out how good DeepSeek VL2 for OCR really is and learn about possible limitations. Okay, let's get started. This is the application we will be using today. These are the commands for setting up the environment, and these are the libraries we are using, along with the Python code. For more details on how to set this up, check out our previous video on getting started with OCR and DeepSeek. We also provide this code in a repo for you to download and try this yourself. Both links are in the description below. These are the questions we are testing with. We'll cover them one by one later in the video. We have four different types of images we are going to use in this video. The first one is an XY chart. Next is an image from our product catalog. The third image contains a math equation. The last image has a table containing information about 20 people with some details like name, age, and occupation. To run, open a terminal and type in Python, followed by the script name. This will take a while to complete as we have 15 different questions we are sending to the model. Some questions and images run faster than others, depending on the complexity. There is a lot of logging going to the screen. The questions and answers follow this format. Okay, the code is finished. Our first question is looking for the highest value on the chart, asking for the value and the date. This answer is correct. The second question is asking the model to extract the table from this image and copy the format. This is 100% correct. The rows and columns and the values contain no mistakes. Looking good so far. Now we ask some detailed questions about specific items in the table. We ask for the country for Lena, and the answer given was Germany, also correct. Then we ask for a name and age of the Canadian. This is correct too. In the next question, we ask for the number of rows. The actual count is 20, but the model returned 21. It may be including the title row. The average given is off by a little. It should be 37.75. This could be related to the previous mistake. Then we ask how old Sophia is, which you got right. The next answer is completely wrong. We would have to investigate why at another time. The name and age match, but 43 years is not the oldest. The next answer is also wrong, but close. Javier is the third oldest. This answer is also wrong. The oldest is 60, not 58. Now we switch to the image with the math equation. This one is correct, the equation matches. It even found the power or x squared term. When we ask to solve for the answer, we only get one. This is a quadratic equation, so it should have two possible solutions. The one given is correct, so this one gets partial credit. Now, we will ask two different questions at the same time. We only get back an answer on one. We tried several different ways to ask this, but only get back one correct answer. The few times we got two answers, only one would be correct. The last image has several cans of chunky soup. The model picked up 15 of 16 labels with no mistakes on those. This image can be difficult as the text is slanted and has different fonts, colors, and backgrounds. When we ask for a marketing statement, we don't get much unless we tell it to be more verbose. When we get the longer answer, it looks pretty good. Okay, the testing is finished. Now for the evaluation. The model does very well with OCR and simpler questions about the text it finds. However, the model only seems to be able to answer one question at a time. It may be better to use this model for extracting the text and then send this text to another model for answering questions about the text that was found. Check out our other videos on OCR where we cover many different model providers, such as OpenAI, Gemini, DeepSeek, and Google Vision. Okay, that's all we have for today. Thanks for watching our video. As always, questions and comments are welcome. See you next time.